and the players arrive on court for this women's preliminary singles match. And we have there playing in the red shirt, Nozomi Kuhara from Japan. Umpire spinning the coin to decide who serves, and her opponent there in the black shirt, Linda Wenny Fenetri. So they decided to change ends. Okuhara, 21 years of age, and there's her opponent. There's Okuhara, world ranked at number 6, lives in Tokyo, made her international debut at the Osaka Challenge back in 2010. Had some good results this season. She's always competed in the latter stages of the big events, quarter finalist in the Indonesian Open Super Series. She was a quarter finalist in the Asian Championships, did well at the All England Championships, and a semi-finalist in the German Open as well. So very consistent at the highest level this season. And there's her opponent, Fenetri, 26 years of age, world ranked at 25, so 19 places separate these two players. She's from Jakarta, made her international debut in New Zealand in 2009. So I would suggest that the highlight of Okuhara's career this season was the All England champion, which of course is one of the biggest events on the calendar. She won that event in Birmingham in the centre of England. Yeah. And the umpire just asking the players to start this match. Again, it is the best of 3 games. Each game is to 21 points. They've only played each other once recently, and that was at the All England Open, which of course Okuhara won, and she beat Fenetri 21-11 21-10. So the heads-to-heads favour the Japanese player. The time before that, we have to go back to 2013 for when they met, and that was at the Malaysian Open, and again Okuhara winning 21-13 21-13. Fenetri has beaten her, but we have to go back to 2012 at the Indian International, and that was a tight affair, but Fenetri coming out on top, 22-20 21-16. So they've both beaten each other. The recent head-to-heads favours Okuhara, and indeed the world rankings favour Okuhara. So the lady in red with her back to the screen, the favourite. Let's see how it progresses. Bowing all round. Japanese players always show a lot of respect to the officials, their opponents, the crowd. So Fenetri to serve, first game, love all.
That one just drops in, which is great for the Indonesian player. Well, actually, it just dropped wide. I thought it was on the line. A bit of judgment by the players. That little net cord helping Okuhara.
Very quick to acknowledge your good fortune here. There you see, just raising her left hand.
Just driving that shuttle into the net. A little bit rushed, letting the shuttle drop below correct level to be able to drive that. Just timing it. Having a change of racket, Fenetri. hip of the racket just to check the string tension and the feel. Now Fenetri with the serve. To the back of the court. She's getting her rhythm, Fenetri. All locked up at two apiece.
Dropped out.
Yeah, it's a very fine line, isn't it? Just trying to keep it so tight to the net. And the shuttle just goes wide of the line. Ogahara now. Lovely cross-court drop. Well disguised. It down very sharply. Very little time there for Okuhara to respond. Nicely played. That's wide too. Well, that one drops in. A terrific rally by both players. Fenetri now with a shuttle. Tied up here at five apiece. Four apiece. Confusion on the score line here. Nice play. Now I believe that will be 6-5. There we go. Correction on the scoreboard now. couple of handy points now for Okuhara. Good attack, dressing forward. She certainly is in good form at the moment, Okuhara. Some outstanding results in 2016. An All-England title, semi-finalists at the German Open, and also quarter-finals at the Indonesian Super Series and the Asian Championships. International debut was in Okasara Challenge in 2010. She's progressed a long way since.
7-8.
So, Panetri, only a point behind at this stage of the match, down 7-8. Still waiting for our scorer to catch up.
So the umpire's calling 8 points each, which unfortunately the electronic scoreboard is not reflecting. So we have a glitch. But the main thing is it's not affecting the players. The scoreboard now jumps into action. But it was 8 points each, but it's a little bit closer now. We were correct at 9-8, we went back to 9-7 and we've now settled on 9-8, which is spot on.
Okuhara takes the point. Terrific rally by both players. Certainly earning every point they receive here. Game interval with a 3-point lead.
The mid game interval, 1 minute, gives the coaches an opportunity to have a chat with their respective players.
Thank you, coach. Linda.
So the players now back on court to recommence after the mid-game interval. And it is the young lady in red, Nozomi Okuhara, who leads 11-8. First game.
Cross court. You can see she really stepped up the pace of that rally, dictating the play, driving the shuttle into the back corners, turning her opponent around, opening up for the cross court. Nicely done. Another block not working for Penetri. This is the biggest margin of the match so far. 5-point lead. Okuhara. Nice finish.
She sends she's up the tempo. She's after the mid-game interval.
Definitely moved it up a gear. Good movement here getting behind that shuttle. Yeah. Looking to really press. Yeah. Yeah, net roll not working there for Metric. She had plenty of time. Just trying to play it too tight. Great rally and great block by Finetri in the end.
Taking their time. Okuhara now with a 6-point lead. Looked very tight for the first 10 points. Looks as though we're in for a long drawn out affair. The players evenly match, but it's Okuhara who's up the ante.
Oh, great angle cross court.
Great example of how she's up the ante with that cross court smash.
It's wonderful speed with the overhead and the racket speed just cutting through there on the angle. Down, wonderful disguise. Placing the shortest part of the court, straight down the line. Yeah. Nice placement. Okuhara now running away of this first game. Only 3 points away from taking it. Play good attacking cross court clear by Finetri.
It's just a little long.
Service over 19.
and that's just wide of the sideline, and it gives Okuhara 10 game points.
Well, she saved 2 game points so far. But Okuhara still with plenty in the bank. Okuhara takes the first game, 21-12. A fault called on the smash down the line. Minetri just touching that shuttle as it goes wide. So in the end, a very comfortable first game to Japan.
Players now back on court for the second game, and the lady in black, Fenetri, has a battle in front of her now. She has to win the remaining 2 games to win the match, and she's up against a player in fine form, Nozomi Okuhara, the winner of the All England Championships earlier this year. And she's lost the first game, but she'll be giving it her all as the second game starts. Lovell.
Oh, nicely played from the back of the court. A great rally to start the second game. Lovely disguise. That one drops in. A bit of misjudgment by Fenetri.
She'll be disappointed with the judgment there, because that was quite easily in, wasn't it?
That one's long. Fenetri just needs to be aware of the drift. at the back of the court, and also she's leaving shuttles at her end. Whether the drift will pull the shuttle back into the line and into the court. Here's a nice attacking flat shot by Akuhara.
Great start by the Japanese player, number 6 in the world. Excellent drop shot from Akuhara. Shrieks of delight from the Japanese player. She now leads 5-1. She's made an excellent start in this second game. For Fenetri. Good smash down the line. Shuttle drifting out over the end line, the baseline, and it is now 6-2 for the 21-year-old from Japan. Drop shots from Akuhara just caught the top of the net cord, fell back on her side of the court. And it's now Japan leading 6-3. Japan lead 7-3, and indeed Akuhara with the service. Good fortune there for Fenetri, but she wins the point. She just needs to towel down. She asks the umpire for permission to do so. Of course, the players have the mid-game interval, a one-minute break, and the first player makes 11 points to towel down. But obviously, the worst thing that can happen is you get perspiration on the court. The court becomes slippy and dangerous. So, as long as the player doesn't abuse the towel and go over every point, common sense prevails. And the backhand drifts out over the sideline. 7-4. Service long.
Service over, 5-8.
And it is now Fenetri to serve. Again, the drop shot from Okuhara. Just trying to delicately return the shuttle over the net. Falls short on her side of the court. And Fenetri doing well here, quite a few points adrift. She's now only 1 point behind the Japanese player. From Okuhara, caught the top of the net. Fenetra had to lift, and a relatively easy smash for the Japanese player. 9-7, Japan with the serve. It's a great cross court from Fenetra. Drifting out over the sideline. Okuhara now back with the serve, leading 10-8. Smash down the line, just going wide. A little bow as she goes off for the mid-game interval. It's a 1 minute break, just see that point again. There's the smash, just going out. So 1 minute to have a chat with the coach and confirmation of the situation on the screen. Okuhara making her way back onto court. Won the first game 21-12, 11-8 up in the second. And it is Japan to serve. Yeah. Great rally. The players having to cover the full court. Twelve-eight. Oh, and the smash on the diagonal, the cross-court smash. A little bit too wide, goes out of the sideline. And the score now 12-9 in favour of Japan. Deep enough, the clearance, mid-court, a relatively easy smash, but very well executed by Fenetri. Here she goes. Once again, the Indonesian player fighting her way back into the game. But in the first game, it was Okuhara who played the stronger badminton at the end of the game. Great drop shot from Okuhara, moving her player all around the court, using the corners, using the drop shot. Fenetri with the serve. Just going for the smash down the forehand. Hits the shuttle into the net. And the lead now down to 1 point. Both players just composing themselves. Fenetri with the serve. Just falling short from Fenetri. Two-point lead for Kuhara, her serve to come. Two great smashes back to back. There's the first There's the second, the body smash from Okuhara. 3-point lead now, 15-12. Looked as though it dropped on the line. Yes, it did. 16-12, great service, very accurate. That's a wonderful drop shot from Okuhara. Pulled out. And that's a run of 4 or 5 points now for Okuhara. The backhand cross court. Out wide of the sideline. Smash down the line from Okuhara. It's a 7-8 point run of points now. So 8 match points for Japan. This time the smash down the backhand line into the backhand of Fenetri, and it is a winner. And Okuhara wins the second game 21-12 and wins the match by 2-0. Waving to the crowd, she'll be delighted. Looked as though it was going to be tough. It was tough in both games until about the halfway stage, but there was no doubt who the stronger player was in the second half of the first game and the second half of the second game. The All England champion looks